So how was sound used to tell stories? And how did sound technicians move from being concerned with questions of technical expertise to applying their knowledge to what one sound engineer called the story values of the film? Well, sound was interlocked with other crafts such as screenwriting and cinematography, and it was really in the collaboration between those crafts that we can see the sound film coming into its own and developing more dynamic style and more sonically focused storytelling. This screenwriting manual from 1936 encourages screenwriters to think about ear appeal and to write for the new cinema form. So Tamar Lane, the author of this book, she encourages screenwriters to think about the ways that sound effects might form an expressive part of the film landscape. So she says, to enumerate only a few, the steaming of kettles, church bells tolling, typewriters clicking, traffic noises, the drone of airplane noises, the pop of champagne corks, birds singing in the spring, and so on. There are three films which might offer case studies of how film sound style was really innovative in the early sound period and the contribution of sound technicians to that sound style. The first is the 1932 film I'm a Fugitive from a Chain Gang, a prison film produced by Warner Brothers which focused on the real-life escape of Robert Burns, a World War I veteran who went on the run after being brutally treated on the Georgia Chain Gang. The sequence includes three different uses of sound. Sound looping, which captures the monotony of the prison routines. Wild sound, recorded and synced with the action as the actor Paul Mooney rushes through the woods and swamp. And finally, a very stylistic and innovative use of sound as he plunges in the river. We can hear very strong sound contrasts, the baying of the bloodhounds above the surface of the water, and plunge into silence with the fugitive as he hides out below. Second example of innovative use of sound effects might be the 1933 film King Kong. This is a well-known monster movie, but of course it required the creation of non-realistic sound effects, or synthesized sound, as technicians referred to this process in this period. RKO sound men Murray Spivak and his assistant Walter Elliott recorded animal sounds in a local zoo and played them at different speeds, and also produced some of King Kong's grunts themselves. The third example of a case study of innovative sound might be the 1942 film Cat People, produced at RKO Studios by Val Lewton's B Film Unit. This sequence is all about suspense, and here is a very disciplined use of sound. The trail through the nighttime streets contrasts just two aspects of sound: footsteps and silence. There's no music, no other ambient sound effects until the explosion of the bus into the scene. So what do these innovative examples of film sound style tell us? Well, I think they point not only to the existence of one or two innovative sound practitioners in this period, but in fact the existence of a whole group of very skilled sound technicians and experts, able to apply technical knowledge to achieve story values and entertainment values that were so important to the Hollywood studios in this period. This book, which is my final object to look at in this film, is Motion Picture Sound Engineering. It's a technical manual published in 1938 and published by the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. And it's a collection of essays by Hollywood's leading sound engineers and sound experts. And in the introduction, Wesley Miller, a senior sound engineer at MGM Studios, talks about the crafts of sound recording. He writes, "The sound man is the brain of the microphone. He guides the technical system to produce the illusion which is desired on the screen." I think this perfectly illustrates how technical knowledge was used to craft the story values of the Hollywood soundscape.